Welcome to part two of our developer playthrough of Protostar's Mill. If you haven't watched part one, I highly suggest doing that. And yeah, let's get on with chapter two, extended relaxation.
Yeah. Oh, and if you just before you jump by, check out the bed. It's all stinking and destroyed right now.
It must have been a very, very comfortable sleep. Ugh.
Yeah, so it was my job then to go through garden and just absolutely trash it, which was fun. In fact, that's pretty much my main job as the mod, like environment designer or just person who destroys all the levels.
Well, yeah, you make a very, very nice looking level and
and a few
then
of my scientists make what's
it
called
gets
long-haul,
destroyed.
I mean, aperture science in
So yeah,
this
as you can see, everything has literally
small
fallen apart,
space.
so something's clearly gone horribly wrong, and obviously you've got Virgil pretending to be Cave Johnson at this point, talking to you. So yeah, they just literally took Garden and then saved it under a new name and then just destroyed it. So this is technically still Garden, but I just ripped it apart.
That yellow device up.
And
Don't
this is a throwback to Half-Life 2 Episode 1,
scientists leave you
where when you get off the train
you
with
to us,
Alex
right?
on the
You
underground
do it.
parking lot bit, there was like turrets that tried to
Congratulations.
shoot you, but they'd run out of bullets because they'd been down there
Now,
for so
I'll
long.
do the experiment for
And
you.
these turrets actually make the exact same noises, so that was my little throwback because I loved the idea that they just completely ran out of bullets after so much time.
And here is the big moment where you pick up the portal gun.
Yeah, the animation and particle effects were designed by Tomas, who of course is working on his own mod repercussions, which we're really excited about. And fun fact, we have seen this pickup animation so many times, we are completely bored of it.
It's
Like
like,
it is.
oh, we have to wait another set of 14 seconds, I believe it is, from the moment.
Yeah. Also, there's a little plaque under it if you read it as well.
Don't worry about that.
Oh,
It's
yes.
just a new
Old
portal that we're
reliable,
going
the
down for.
first amateur handheld portal device to have
Need
three
more to get
healthy
more advanced
surviving
spirit things.
users.
Yeah, that's it.
Sorry, that's totally safe,
You know
don't
that.
worry.
And Jake came with a wonderful idea for this room, as a sort of relaxation chamber type thing with like a fake painted like walls and stuff. And my favorite is at the very back of the room where you're looking roughly, there's a little aperture
Yes.
logo as a sunset, which I just love because I don't know if you realize, but we love the 70s logo, which is why it's incorporated into Virgil's eye design, just because it's such a 70s logo. But yeah, for the sort of puzzle. Well, it's more so it's like to sort of get you slowly back in. Like we don't really do any of the training that like other portal games do. Like we assume that you already know how to fire your portals and stuff, but I basically make you have to wind your way through the entire like building that's all destroyed now. So you know, it kind of makes full use of the entire building, and it's something that Valve tends to like doing, where you'll like see areas and then you'll be forced to like wind your way through the whole thing rather than be able to just cut straight through it, which you can do in Garden. Like you can ignore all the other side rooms.
And what's really funny for me is that I started with this map and this specific room back in like June 2011. Like, this is probably the oldest chamber in the mod, and it's amazing to see what happened to it, how Steven destroyed it.
You'll be saying that a lot over the course of this, but yeah,
Yeah.
as you can see here, like you know, you're having to wind your way through, and this is this little simple puzzle of having to jump back out the window and stuff like that. So it's just, you know, you're forced to sort of wind your way around the facility to get out, and it's cool. And if you're in garden, you see it, but like as you can
Well,
see, like
still,
I
we've
updated the computers to be more modern, and if you
five
just
of
stop
our
here,
brains
I made a funny logo
in
joke,
that
which we
facility.
used quite a lot. But basically, they have like the really fancy stencil logo type thing in the originally, and then we figured by this point, like when they're known as just Aperture, which is again why the portal gun's just called AHPD rather than the ASHPD, which it will be in the later games. But basically, they could only afford like a rubbishy poster, and they couldn't even afford to scrape the like old one off, so they just slapped their new poster right on top of the old one. Just that's how poor they were.
And this is supposed to be a very, very early prototype of Aegis. And like, it's getting expanded upon and upon and upon, and eventually becomes the boss at the end of the game. Spoilers.
And yeah, again here, just collapsed floors and all sorts of stuff. I tried to keep the reveal of really what it's like outside quite hidden. If you look, I put like fractured glass at the end, so it makes it a bit more distorted when you're looking out, so you can't really get the full reveal yet. And you don't really see that well like over here, so it's not until you fling out that you really get like the best view. And you'll see like everything's completely different. But like as I said, this is still technically the original level, but I just went and like did all this over the top of it basically.
Yeah, and like over here we have a bunch of sparks coming down to try to focus you a little bit more on the upside area, because there is a portable surface over there. And it's slightly better to see from the other side.
I also added in as you can see there, a placement helper, just because you can go upstairs and get a really good shot of it, but like being lazy and doing this level like about 30 or 40 times, you eventually want a faster way to shoot up there.
So this is also another fairly funny thing. You have these turrets here, and like this guy is like aimed at the door, so like people that come in here would get shot by this guy, so he is out of bullets, but these guys can actually still shoot you because they have been facing towards the wall.
Yeah, plus it's a cruel trick, you're like, oh, all the turrets are out of bullets. Nope. Oh, and while you're in here, Anna, just one thing I wanted to point out as well, like with the detailing, I tried to sort of tell a story as well. Like you can see that all the fancy comfy chairs have been replaced by just rubbishy chairs, because this was the point where they were hiring like homeless people, and there's just boxes of like paper and forms and paperwork that they would have had to fill out. Like, you know, you can really tell that it's definitely fallen from glory. Same if you go upstairs as well, you can show off some of the other stuff we did. So yeah, I tried to sort of do a bit of subtle storytelling in the level itself. So like here it was just like storage and junk and everything was just thrown in here.
Yeah, and like instead of a catwalk, it's now offices and desk crammed in. Like, this was a nice relaxing thing. No, you have to work here.
And of course we still have our old favourite looking at cave, and the cave dancing pictures did it. And also if you look through that doorway, you can see where you actually were when you jumped through the hole and stuff. So it's like this kind of level where, like, as I said, it's something Val particularly liked to do, where you can like look back and see where you've been and stuff. But yeah, like this puzzle is sort of based off your original orange gel ramp idea. Remember way back when you ramped off the bridge, like into the hole in the wall? Like,
yes.
It then just became smashing your face in the window on the way out.
And like, you can hit that glass, and if you hit the glass, all these gips fall down. And if you don't hit the glass, they just stay there.
Yeah, also there's a chance that you might fly into the lake, but that's very rare. I don't think I've actually ever managed to do it. And as you can see here, like, I built loads of extensions and stuff to really hit home like how much stuff has changed. Like you thought, you know, oh, it's just stuff's destroyed and collapsed, and then you see that there's all this extra work that has been done like in the meantime.
Yeah,
so there's
like extra piping and
And like even the extra stuff is also destroyed.
Yeah, and the grass here is completely dried out, like it was green at some point, and like all the trees are completely leafless and dead.
Yeah, and there's like a whole gel pumping station, like the car parks, it's just where everyone parks their fancy cars, is just taken over. Well, that's another subtle thing as well, like in the lift map you can actually see where the cars would have got on the lifts and stuff. Like if you look at the second thing over here, you can see it's a ramp compared to the stairs. So this was like where the cars would, you know, get off and stuff. And again, this is like a black, well, I have like one reference where you could go back to your original tram. Although you couldn't get onto it, like, once all the stuff had happened, like the resonance cascade, and here you can see the lift that, well, you were on, it's all destroyed.
Yeah, still some blue paint splatters.
Yeah, if you actually look up, I put, like, a little, above the paint splatter, I put, like, a little vent thingy there, so it is actually under that and stuff. Like, that's the level of detail that I try to go for.
And this is pretty much where the loading screen for Act 2 is.
Oh no, Act 1 you're thinking of, that was the clean garden. Act 2 is...
No, Act 1 is facing that building, and Act 2 is with the water and the pipes.
Oh yeah, you're thinking of the menu screen.
The menu screen, yes, my bad.
And here, again, I decided to go for like an underground railway thing, because we found some random train models, I think it's from the Super 8 trailer. So, I go up with... the idea of just, like, it was that big again. You know, they had to have their own railways for transporting materials about.
Come to think of it, these guys would never fit through these doors, but it's aperture.
They used portals, of course.
Shit, of course. And, yeah, this is the vault room that I've worked on a lot.
Yeah, what do you mean you've worked on a lot? You designed this room.
Yeah. yeah, this started off with, like, I want to do something with the vault door. To, like, have the transition between, like, over here, like, this is clearly, like, office-y, and, like, it wouldn't really make sense to go from there into a test chamber, so you had to have some transition area. Which the transition seals are very, very good for. And so yeah, that's how this came to be.
Yeah, and then you come with the power puzzle, turning the power on and off and stuff, which is just something a little bit different.
And I love the shadows of the rejected texture here. Which all comes from that little light there.
That's a very powerful light.
Yeah.
Yeah, basically, one other thing that we sort of jokingly did is trying to outdo each other with really fancy projected textures, which are, like, if you don't know, they're, like, things that provide, like, the best shadows in Source games, because for the most part it's all
static. Dynamic shadows.
Yeah, it's usually all static pre-baked lighting, whereas they allow you to do, like, dynamic moving lights and, like, really high-quality shadows and stuff. So it was always a sort of goal to beat each other with the best-looking projected texture.
And then we have the switchy thing, which is also in Portal 2, like the two different switches you have to flip, but like we assume that like it's so important that you should do it with two people at the same time, but you know.
Also has some water dripping off the vault door here. Just to go in a little bit of detail, because like it's all submerged. In fact, you used to be able to go down there, it was part of the puzzle, but it was so confusing to people that we decided to change it. Because people will get stuck in here.
And this is incredibly cruel. The power turns on again, and also this grid. So if you were standing over there admiring this thing open, you would be zapped. Because you're just that pointlessly cruel.
But yeah, I love that it's just such a... Again, it's sort of similar to Evolved, but like it's a very small room behind the vault door. Like, in fact, it's smaller than the vault door itself. You can see like it doesn't even reach the full circle.
Yeah.
Which is sort of quite a juxtaposition. But yeah, and also I love that inset vent.
And this this is a part, like the next part over here. It's made by iWork95, and it got highly reworked and reused.
Yeah, you used to go through it, but now it's pretty much just detailed.
Yeah, there was like a broken window, you would go in there and then through some offices and then... And they're pretty much in here again, and like some of those corridors like got sort of collapsed into here.
Yeah. And coming up is the part that made us jump all the time, because we every single time, even though we know it's gonna come, we always forgot about it.
Yes, so headphone users be warned.
Yeah, this like big beam, which can actually damage you and knock you off if you happen to be running out, just comes down and makes a massive noise and scares the crap out of you, basically.
Pretty much.
But yeah, so you're walking precariously along some pipes and vents to get to your first test chamber.
Yeah, and this is already some sort of training towards something you will do later, and like... you can see, like, over there is a broken-off catwalk, and this part is broken off, so you're like... It's sort of telegraphs, like, you were able to just walk over here, and now you have to use the piping.
Yeah, we try to do that as much as possible, like, you know, storytelling using the level, like, if you have to really be paying attention to pick this stuff up, but, like, you know, it all adds up, like, getting all the little details in, like, there's so much detail. But yeah, in this loading screen, if you'll notice, there's actually some floating pillars, because part of the level was moved, yeah, right there, and we forgot to move those. Need to say that's already been fixed, and it will be in the release version, but it's funny for this.
Yeah, and this little power-up sequence is... once again to indicate that like this track hasn't been used for a very long time, and like it's specifically turned on for you. Hold on.
Yeah, by Virgil. And yeah, something I wanted to do around here, like you're standing on it right now, is like, I did this a lot, like just having bits of sheet metal and wood that was used to repair it, like Valve talked about, what was it, Caretaker Gym or something like that? Or like they sort of designed it, this like, per like Janet or whatever, had to like fix the levels up with just whatever he had, so I put in a lot of the levels just like, you know, bits of sheet metal and bits of wood that had just been stuck to the floor to hold the place together.
Yeah, and this puzzle has undergone significant changes. I think that the first iteration of this map was also made somewhere in 2011, so that's one of the older maps. And it used to feature a high energy pellets, and it's really confusing actually. I can't remember the exact specifics. And pretty much the only thing we kept from the very original is this jump over here.
There's also an amazing speedrun that we saw Xenericus do, and when I was detailing this level, I specifically made sure that all the vents and stuff were designed in such a way that he could still do it by like running along the roofs and like crazy bounces and stuff. It's just amazing, pretty much. Basically, we decided that if we can't pull something off, then it's fine to stay in the mod, pretty much, with regards to speedrunning stuff. And me and Anna are not the best at, like, bunny... We're like, I can't even bunny hop at all.
And this is one of my favorite little puzzles in the mod.
Yeah, you originally designed this in PTI as a quick mock-up.
Yes, and it's surprisingly little work was required to... changes over to an actual level.
Yeah, to make it old aperture style. But I just love, like, it's deceptively difficult, like, but, you know, it's actually super simple. You're not dead. That means that high toxicity lead didn't get in the air. And that is the first level. Great job, Olympian, so, war hero, you really it was fun doing the detailing. Like I mean, old aperture maps are very sort of cut up and like you've really used all sorts of various textures and tiles and gratings and stuff, and like as I said, just throwing bits of like plywood to like cover up holes and stuff. So it's quite interesting to work with.
And what's really funny about the previous map, it's called Underbands, and this map is called One Spawn, and since those two maps existed, we've messed the names up. Whoops.
Hold on.
Yeah. We've like endlessly never been able to get the names of these maps right. We always call them the wrong thing. And yes, Anna just put all the other side of the level. Well done.
You can't actually use it though. And so in the previous test you had, well, like in in the garden level, you had some orange gel, and in the previous level, you had some blue gel, and this is a combination of the two.
What's interesting about this is Anna designed this puzzle, and the second room was designed by me, but we weren't really satisfied with them both, and then we both fixed each other's puzzles in the end,
yes.
And they turned out like so much better than their originals. And I forgot how to solve her own puzzle.
Oh yeah, I always do that, that's okay.
Yeah, somehow, like, despite having played these maps, playing this whole mod over and over and over and over, sick of it, like, we can barely get any enjoyment out of this after working on it for so long, but like, you know, we still forget how to solve our own puzzles. Which I'm not sure if that's a bad thing or not.
Yeah, it's certainly a hard mod, let's...
Yeah, but I would say that we're not unfair. Like, no. We're not like, what was it, Portal Pro or something?
Oh.
I forget which one it was, and like, that was an extremely difficult, like, loads of, like, precise flings and stuff.
Yeah, like, we tried to, like, keep the difficulty in solving the puzzles, and, like, once you know how to solve the puzzle, it should be fairly easy to actually pull it off.
I'm not sure if it was Portal Prelude and Portal Pro. One of them was Mavius's one or something, I can't remember, I always get them mixed up as well. Yeah, one of them was insanely difficult, that's all I'll say. This is a rather unusual way of solving it, but...
Yeah, it's a fairly complicated and silly way of doing it, but it's fine.
Alright, oh,
hold up a second, Mel. I don't think you're
that stupid that you're going to fall for this.
But yeah, like the previous tests, then the first with orange and blue gel. And that way we try to keep the new test elements fairly limited to...
Well, they're not really new, but, you know, just to get you back into the swing of things again. Like, if you haven't played Portal 2 in a while. But, like, we didn't want to go with the whole, you know, put a cube on a button style tests. Like, we're sick of mods starting with that. Because, like, everyone knows how to do that. You don't need to start us off with that. Like, anyone who's going to be playing a mod will be most likely someone who's played the base game.
Yeah, especially because you actually have to own the base game, like...
Yeah, it'd be quite weird to play this mod without having played either Portal or Portal 2. Yeah. I mean, I'm sure there will be one person somewhere who might do it, but, like, goodness help them.
Good luck, I would say to you. And up next is Past Power, which we released 2.5 years ago, is it, on the Steam Workshop, and as you can see, it looks nothing like that anymore. It's completely revamped.
This level's been, I'd say, revamped possibly the most of every level.
Yeah.
I mean, like, Intro and Garden all went through a hell of a lot of changes, but, like... This is just, it doesn't just get changes, this gets just completely redesigned. Like, the puzzle and everything is completely different. And also, we sort of skipped over it, but, like, quote-unquote Cave Johnson has just revealed that he's actually Virgil.
Yes. And, yeah, we use that to give a little bit more character to Virgil, and like you don't want to wake someone up like, oh whoops, it's actually it's not the 1950s, it's actually 2000 something something.
Yeah, 20XX as Valve always calls it.
Yeah.
Well, just a note, we haven't really pointed out, but yeah, the gun and all the animation stuff, well, the model for the gun was designed by Rachel, and the textures were designed by Jake, and then Tomas did the animations, which are really good, like, on the gun, and, like, I don't know if you noticed, there's, like, a paperclip, like, on one of the, like,
prongs.
Jaw things, and, like, it glows whenever you pick up objects, and, like, I love the rotary part inside, and, like, it also has its neutral, like, greeny glow and stuff, like, even the gun looks like it's kind of, like, taped together.
Whoops. That is my, Steam not being offline, even though I told it to. Whoops. But yeah, so that's the first puzzle, and I try to keep the elements of the original puzzle, although the original had a laser as well, which is totally out of place in this time. But like, the fling is still here, and I try to keep the core elements of the puzzle and figure out another way to make an interesting puzzle out of it.
Well, something I like as well is that you included the blue gel, like the pipe's broken here, but like in the level itself you can see where it would have connected, and you can even see where you would have put the blue gel to bounce up and stuff.
Yeah, that was kind of the idea, like to give the idea that it could have been solved without a portal gun but with blue gel. And you can actually make this jump, and if you do, then this starts sparking and stuff. And this would then also indicate again, like, you would go out here, but instead we're getting out of the testing track.
Yeah, this was a sort of interesting area to design. Like, you sort of left it quite blank, and then I just sort of threw loads of pipes and stuff on it. And again, with the whole, like, right there, you're seeing like the blue pumping station, and you will eventually go there, so it's like you're seeing where you're going to go, like, before you go there.
Yeah. And then once again, like, this looks very important, and this orange gel looks very important, but you will get shot if you go in here.
Yeah, these turrets aren't out of bullets.
No, they're deadly. And this was very, very tricky. because these are concrete pillars, but the difference between the, well, dark grey and the white, it's fairly hard to see from down below, but with some extra warm lighting secretly near all these, we hope you have found it. And there are voice lines that play if you don't, like, hey, look up. Woo. And then a very subtle cross.
Put your portal here, please. Yeah, there's an arrow there as well, like, shut up, okay.
Look up! Oh, there's a cross.
You should probably turn your Steam thing like shift.
Yes, I will. There we go. To help you get past those turrets. But yeah, then you have this pumping station here, which is completely collapsed. And accidentally, this didn't line up, and so we made a funny voice line out of it.
Yeah, we're like, you fling, and it's like, oh, most people usually fly through the window, because it usually is like all the flings. It's like you just perfectly, you know, things are designed exactly so that you always fling straight through and stuff. And we deactivate the turrets. I think this is quite possibly the oldest room in the mod.
Yes, because at one point I joined the mod team. I wasn't the person who started the mod team. And there was a very, very old level, and it had these sets of pipes in it, and like they've made it through like 4 years of development, and they're still in there, and like,
you know, the one with the giant wheel on it. Do it again. It'll open this time, I swear.
Yeah, there was the two original people who sort of started Portal Stories, and then they like, left it and gave up, and then it's just you were left in your room to carry on the mod.
Yeah, so I ended up getting a whole bunch of new people, and I think it turned out pretty well. It's absolutely like, I couldn't have imagined back in 2011 that this mod would turn out to be this big.
Or that you'd still be working on it in 2015.
Yeah.
There's also some Cave Johnson doors scattered about the place.
Yes!
So you can get some funny lines similar to they did in the Portal 2 game. And I tried to detail each door with suitable, like, stuff, depending on the line. This is the one about grizzly bears and lions and stuff, I think.
Yeah, it's Virgil is still talking. You should have gotten that silver medal. The local zoo made an offer we couldn't refuse, so you may encounter several grizzly bears and or lions in this next test. And once again, like, it's explorational based here, and like, you can see all these things, and you can see directly into the test chamber, so like, I can imagine like people sitting here and be like, I want to look at what the test subjects are doing.
Yeah, like, we tried to put like so much detail into absolutely everything, like, whether much of it gets noticed or not.
Yeah.
But I think someone at Valve once said, like, the better you do your job, like, the less anyone notices you've done anything at all. I even stole some cobwebs from Left 4 Dead 2, like, they're from where sporadically in this map, like, on the roof.
I actually don't see them, they should be here.
They might have got deleted in this map, but they're
no,
in a couple
No, they're here. I know that there's at least one over here. Oh yeah, there it is.
Yeah, they're really hard to see, but yeah,
they're
just
there.
That's how abandoned it's been. And this thing, this part has been probably through, like, so many changes as well.
Yes. And eventually we came up with this, where you can very, very clearly see the testing sphere, which will match up with the next two levels, which is really, really cool. And over here you have an exit.
Don't get me wrong.
It's boarded off, obviously, after like everything got closed down.
They boarded it up when they kept building above this facility.
And again, at the end here, there's a doorway with one of the Cave Johnson lines, which actually I think was one of my favourite lines.
But we'll let you discover that yourself.
And our good luck just ran out.
Yeah, like, this is a test chamber, but it's actually not functional, but it should give the impression that it is.
Yeah, there's a little observation room and all that you can go into and have a look and stuff. And see what people who worked here would have seen. Nothing of much interest.
Like,
drinking lots of
coffee. It's actually, yeah. That's really important, coffee.
Yeah, if you look at the left building itself, I went for like a sort of ribbed-y style structure. Just thought it looked really cool. Just put numbers and stuff up, but just it used to be just a big flat wall, and I didn't particularly like that.
This is actually the number I was talking about earlier. This is the 23 that was from April 2014, and this was later, like, on the 20th of April this year, 2015. I was when I was working on it again. I was like, ooh, that's a long time ago.
So yeah, it used to be like this crazy like blue and orange gel jump that never worked half the time, so we eventually just gave up and just went with something a bit simpler.
And this is a really funny technical thing. You see here that the elevator goes into the dome, and like there is a hole for elevators in some dome models, but this has to be in a very specific orientation, not to clip into like everything that's here. Like, this is like into the concrete, and so it had to be positioned fairly precisely. So once you actually go into the elevator, like, these models get deleted, so you don't clip through them when you go up the lift. It's really funny.
The nice thing about this catwalk where you go in the lift is just how close and low it is to the water. Like, pretty cool. And also to the left you can see like buildings, which, as mentioned, you can actually like see those buildings once you've completed actually the next level coming, and then you're in the level after that because it's set like high above this.
Yeah, and you should also be able to see this.
Yeah, you can actually see, like, it's so bad. I did copy and paste it in, but it's so far away that it's just completely, like, a faded, silhouette-y outline.
Yeah, so you will, we will go up here and then not hit the dome, because it secretly gets deleted here.
And again, like, a very old map which doesn't even have its name anymore. We refused to call it its new name, which we had to for character limitations on the levels, which is now, it's not called Ramp or something, but to us it's always going to be Don't Meet Virgil.
Yeah, this is also, like, yeah, as said, probably, like, mid-2011, the first iteration of this level. And this is where you would first meet Virgil, and you would hold him, and then the gravity would be lowered, and it was a fun idea, but it was really, really annoying, and like the gameplay was terrible. So fairly early on, that already got deleted, and then, well, because we didn't meet Virgil anymore, it became Don't Meet Virgil, and the map has changed since.
But yeah, we're too used to. It was one of the last things done. Like, it was only been recently renamed, and like, we're too used to calling it.
Yeah, it's like less than a month before release that this map got renamed for technical reasons.
I think it used to have white gel as well, I remember, at one point.
Yes.
That's a very long time ago.
And this puzzle is a throwback to the Portal 1 mechanics, where like you did way more with like keeping your portals in momentum and stuff.
Yeah, and like reusing the same portal and stuff. which I remember getting stuck on for ages. I think it was like level like 9 or something, or was it later? I can't remember. It's been a while.
And this is the first time you will hear ages.
Yeah. Also, fun fact, I added some detailing and trusses and stuff for the projected texture, pretty much. This was at the point, as mentioned, we were trying to outdo each other with fancy projected textures, and like, this truss model makes really nice shadows, but you would actually hit your head off it, so there's a very subtle trigger push which nudges you onto the platform, and a player clip above you to stop you getting your head wedged in the trusses.
Yeah, and like, we do that a lot with these kind of flings to just make it slightly easier.
Yeah, we're nice like that. I mean, we never really went to like the Valve level, where in a couple of places they would actually swap your portal for you. Like, that's possibly a bit too hand-holdy, but I suppose for the particular part that they used it on, it was fine, but...
Yeah, this paint dropper is dropping blue gel. That's only because... Yeah, well, it needs to be there to bounce, and if you were to do what I just did and like spray over with orange gel, like this way, it just always replaces it.
Yeah. Also, once I think I got orange gel underneath the lift, somehow.
Impressive.
Fun fact about this jump is that you always smash your head, like you just like choke or like wind yourself on that thing.
Your neck is.
And yeah, during the last section of this level, it's all shaking and exploding and stuff because Aegis is up to no good.
And you will see more of that in the next level!
Yeah, Firestorm, I think, was again like one of my bigger levels that I just like did entirely myself. Like, it wasn't just environment design, like I did a lot of level design as well, so I made this whole part, and then this was actually when I got Tomas on the team to do, he had custom crane animations in his trailer for Repercussions that he did, and I asked him like if he could, originally asked him if I could use one of his, and then not only did he agree, he also made a custom one just for us, and so he designed this like crane animation for this room, and did an amazing job. Like, there's like 140 bones on that thing, and like, he like hand animated that himself.
Whee!
And yeah, so there you can see some of the buildings that you were actually able to see in Passport, like that big one with the number 7 on it, and the white pipes that lead like down the side and stuff.
And over there, you can like, vaguely still see the shapes of these guys.
Yeah, the lift, like, it's just a very faded silhouette. I don't even think you'll be able to see, like, once it's compressed.
No, probably not.
Also,
yeah, there's a little flash when this building explodes, and this was back in a time when we were still very, very busy with outdoing each other with projected textures, so this is like a 0.3 seconds projected texture.
Yeah, just flashes.
Yeah.
That was my favourite one to add. It comes on for 0.3 seconds, and that's it. And there's a light, I don't think anyone really notices, a light falls off, which has a projected texture on it, and it tumbles down, creating like really, really nice shadows on the rock and stuff.
Yeah, and then again, like,
on that little fall that you did there, we have to land like very narrowly on this. Again, there's actually a trigger push that gently nudges you so that you won't overshoot it, because it is a pretty annoying kind of thing to do.
And yeah, this room has like 4 different projected textures, because once again here, as soon as the lift comes down, you get another very nice moving one.
Yeah.
And what's really funny here is you can choose to take either the stairs or the lift. It doesn't really matter which one you take. And they both have a line where Virgil is complaining about you taking your chosen route.
Yeah, you can't win. Also, I massively updated this room. Originally, didn't have all the buildings at the side, and then I realized it was just too boring. And also, interestingly, I noticed that like in the Valve caves and stuff, like there were never any stalagmites and stalactites, which as you can see I've added, and actually I think I only ever made about 4 of them and just copied and pasted, and they're actually displacements, and then I just was able to like drag and change the shape and size of them just to kind of add a bit of variety to the ceiling and make it look quite ominous. And here we have a little bit of a training thing. We've got some fire, and as you walk towards it, some water dumps on it and puts it out. Now, this seems silly, like it's obvious, you know, the water puts out fire, but you really do have to train that to the player, like, because it's, for some reason, just when you're playing a game, like, people just forget, like, really obvious stuff like that, and it was a complaint that people didn't realize that you know, water would put out the fire. So that was just a little subtle training thing that you see it happen in front of you. And again, like, if you look to your right, the little window, you can see water dripping out of this pipe, like, very slightly, which is a little hint of what's coming up. And of course, there's a portal surface in it.
Bam!
So that explodes. You can follow the red pipes as well, which I don't think anyone will ever notice. They follow and lead exactly to where the fire's coming out of. And there's even a little broken bit, and you can see. And I don't know whether that's of any help to anybody, but just think you just come in here and hit the lever and it all blows up.
BAM!
So, I did some model swaps, so you can see this is the same room, and I just like have some hidden models which would like make it look like part of it's collapsed and stuff, and the glass is broken, so you can put the fire out.
BAM! And then the fire is supposed to go out. Oh, it's not the updated version yet, is it?
No. Yeah, the way it works, obviously, because the way that the water works is obviously the water doesn't actually put fire, right? The fire's just a particle system, but,
I think I broke it. Whoops.
Yeah.
I'll just, oh, whoops. No clip through here. Wow. If you'd been there a few seconds earlier, and that's, like, it's a few days before release, so it will be fixed on release, don't worry.
Fun stuff. But yeah, it's to do with like portal detectors and stuff, because the water doesn't actually put fire out, it's just a particle effect, so it's just, is your portal here, is your portal here, then the water's coming out, okay, you know, job's done.
So here you can cheat and jump over, and we specifically, like, this is the intended route you take.
There's also an instructor hint, if you didn't realize, that you can pick up the crates, and like, I wanted to do a sort of Half-Life 2 style, like, physics puzzle, so to speak, where basically you have to stack some boxes up to reach a portal surface that's out of your reach. Like, it's very, very basic. But just a sort of a nice little throwback to these kind of puzzles that you would have done in Half-Life 2. And also, it was very annoying because I had to make sure that the players wouldn't go out of their way to, like, trap themselves. And Anna's having a very hard time putting the boxes. You don't really need to stack them like that. I even secretly lowered the height of the surface a little bit just so that it would be easier to do. But yeah, I had to put all sorts of clips and stuff to prevent the player from like throwing the cubes upstairs and stuff and trapping themselves forever, which wouldn't be nice.
And that's actually a very challenging thing in level design to to figure out all the ways that people can potentially get themselves trapped. And like, we've had playtesters in the mod for a good couple of months, and like, that's been super helpful in figuring out a lot of those things. And thanks for all everyone's input. It really helped sort us out these kind of issues.
Yeah, the number of crazy things the playtesters would pull up is just ridiculous. But yeah, these are levels that are still being partially tweaked, as obviously the fire was broken, but this is like after the review copies have been sent out, and there was no problems with that. It was just, there's like one minor kind of problem, so...
Yeah, it's actually, I know what went wrong here. And it's a fairly easy fix.
So thankfully the reviewers didn't get that in theirs. So.
No, it's I know exactly what happened, and it's not a review.
Because that would have been horrible.
Yep.
No reviewers, oh, you're stuck. Oh yeah, and this is very subtle, if anyone can even notice this. The pump station delta thing here, which is a water pump station, was actually done by Jake. Like, it fits in perfectly with the style of the ones that are actually in-game, and I've had people question, like, oh, I don't remember seeing that in-game, like, is that from Portal 2? I'm like, no, that's actually a custom one that was made for us.
Oh.
And also, there's some water dripping from the ceiling to give you a bit of a clue.
Yeah, and over here I added a little staircase that wound it down and gave the most terrible fizzly flavor.
Yeah, you do not want to know how long it takes to do a spiral staircase in Hammer. Like, it's not fun. But yeah, this whole room was redesigned by me. It was originally made by Chris, and then me and you, like, well, you completely redesigned the office, and then I designed the exterior again and again. It's sort of a nice little puzzle, and nice little watery, fiery puzzle, which I think was Christopher Livingston did the PC Gamer review. He tended, he said in his review specifically that he like enjoyed these fire puzzles.
Those guys. I remember those guys.
And here was one of, I think, the room that I'm the most happy with, how it came out, this vault room, which was made by me, and it was a huge undertaking. Like, basically, those vault doors are massive, and when you stick them in a level, and at the point when I was making it, obviously I just had like a floor and that's it to give me to work out how big the room needed to be. I didn't really have a clue what I was going to put in this room, like, apart from a very rough idea of a puzzle. And like, it's, I'm just incredibly proud of how it all turned out in the end, and like the projected texture when it opens and stuff. But this is just sort of, you know, using the blue and the orange gels to get where you need to go, and like activating pumping stations that pumps the gels up into modern aperture. Which is sort of a throwback to what they did in Portal 2, but perhaps the gel here is getting pumped up to different parts than the parts where gel goes.
Yeah, obviously we're in different testing tracks, so like, they obviously have different pump stations.
Oh yeah, and I don't know if you've noticed, but we completely ignore white gel because we don't particularly like it. Poor white gel.
What has it ever done to me except get me stuck in the very first puzzle it uses in Portal 2?
Yeah.
I hate that puzzle.
So here, if you stop, you can see one of my favourite protected textures, if I do say so myself, and we actually had to ask Valve to fix protected textures, because at one point during development they broke them with an update to Portal 2, and at this time we weren't fully separated from Portal 2 as a standalone mod, and then they were kind enough to, they couldn't replicate it, but they were kind enough to revert back to their older way. And you have some dust that comes out at the bottom of the vault when it smashes against the wall. And this lift that's coming down is literally... It was the worst thing imaginable. It looks simple, but it's like two funk doors and path tracks and ropes and everything. It's just a complete nightmare. And like, to get this working, I spent hours and hours and hours and hours. And then the worst thing was, it was built separately and then had to be attached to the rest of the Firestorm map. And then I had to redo the lift because the orientation of the map changed. So I hate this lift, even though it does make nice shadows.
Yeah, and like this, gives you some time to see everything again.
Also, if you look, you can see the gel like coming from old, and I wanted to do a really cool connection, and like it was very fun doing this transition from the very old style to the very new style, and I think I pulled it off pretty well. But I kind of, you know, was obviously inspired by the one that they did in Portal 2, and like it's nice to look down over the edge and like see the vault room and stuff. And then if you look out, you can see like chambers with like loads of little lights on them, like up here. Oh. And that looks a lot bigger than it is, which is quite funny. It's actually only 512 units, which isn't that big, but by using little teeny tiny lights and stuff, it makes it look like that area is so much bigger than it actually is.
Yeah, and so what's also really funny is that the pump stations actually activate these things here as well. So if you don't turn on the pumping station, they won't show. And yeah, so if someone speedruns the game and skips like the blue gel, like you'll only see the orange gel.
Although I'm not sure if that's possible, but
no,
you never...
but it's fun to know. And yeah, that brings us to the end of chapter 2.
Yep.
And that's old Aperture, and we are going into new Aperture. And we'll end the video now, and we'll continue with part number 3.